Hello, I am Flash Isaac. Today, I shall be taking you through the atomic theories. Democritus, a Greek teacher, a scientist, in the 4th century, first suggested atoms. As at then, we didn't know much about atoms. No idea. Meanwhile, in 1808, John Dalton gave us the earliest idea, the suggestion, the introduction, the things we should know about atoms, which is Dalton's atomic theory. Before we go into Dalton's atomic theories, up till the present, what do we know about atoms? An atom or atoms are the smallest particle of element or substance that can take part in chemical reaction. The smallest particle. Look at this. Chemistry is the study of the composition, properties, and uses of matter. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Virtually, the air we breathe, this guy, water, things we see around, they are matter. And the opposite of matter is energy, which is referred to as antimatter. What is matter composed of? All matter are composed of atoms. So atoms are the unit of matter. If we agree that this is a matter, this matter is made up of billions and billions and billions and billions of atoms. Atoms are so small that you cannot see them with your naked eye. Apart from being so small, or the unit of matter, everything you see, human beings, the build-up, the smallest unit, is atoms. So, apart from the fact that atoms are so small, or they are unit of existence, they can't exist independently. Atoms cannot exist independently. They don't exist independently. So, atoms choose to combine to exist as molecules, which means one molecule is made up of atoms. Molecule is a steady state which atoms can combine. If you look at chlorine, chlorine exists as molecule. One molecule of chlorine is Cl2, and this molecule of chlorine contains two atoms of chlorine. So this is referred to as diatomic because it has two atomics. Oxygen is O2, hydrogen is H2. They are diatomic. Sodium is Na, it is monoatomic. So molecules can contain three atoms. So molecule is a substance which is the smallest part of a substance that is capable of independent existence. It can exist on its own and retain the property of that substance. Since atoms cannot exist on their own, molecules, they are the smallest part of any substance that can exist on their own. They are made up of atoms. When molecules are made up of the same type of atoms, they are referred to as elements. When molecules are made up of different types of atoms, they are referred to as compounds. So, elements are pure substance. Compounds are pure substance, while mixtures are impure. That is said that all matter or elements are made up of small indivisible particles called atoms. All matter elements are made up of small indivisible particles called atoms. Two, that is said that all an atom can never neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Which means during a chemical reaction, atoms are not created, atoms are not destroyed. 3. Dalton told us that atoms of the same elements are identical in all aspects and they are different from atoms of other elements. Which means atoms of the same element, they have the same mass, the same shape, the same structure. And atoms of different elements, they have different shape, different mass, different structure. And Dalton said that when atoms combine, they do so in simple ratio. And finally, that made us to understand that all chemical reactions involves only the separation, combination, or rearrangement of atoms. We see that Dalton is regarded as the father of atomic structure. He gave us a lot of beautiful theories. Are these all correct? No. No. There are a lot of failures in these theories, and we have success. Despite that, Dalton is somebody we should respect because he first of all made attempt of the atomic theory before other persons, other scientists started improving. The first one says, all matter are made up of small indivisible particles called atoms. This is partially true in the sense that all matter or elements, everything around, they are made up of atoms. But atoms are not indivisible. They are small, correct? All matter are made up of atoms, correct? But this part of atoms being indivisible is wrong. And this was when men like Eugene Goldstein discovered protons, James Chadwick discovered neutrons, and J.J. Thompson discovered electrons. With that, we discover that atoms, they have what we refer to as subatomic particles. Which means, if this is an atom, we have, inside the atom here, we have nucleus. In this nucleus, we have proton and neutron. Protons and neutrons. Then around the nucleus, electrons, they revolve. Electrons are negatively charged particles. Protons are positively charged particles, while neutrons are particles with no charge. All these are subparticles of atoms. And there is even a theory that even proton has subparticles called quarks. Therefore, atoms are divisible. They have other subparticles. They are not the smallest indivisible particles. So we prove this wrong. Then, an atom can neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Normally, this is one of the success of Dalton's atomic theory to an extent, because it helped us to explain the law of conservation of matter, the law of multiple proportion, the law of constant composition. That helped us. I have a video on that, the law of chemical combination. Take a look at that. I'll share a link to it. It really helped. For example, the law of conservation of mass. If hydrogen reacts with oxygen, will form H2O. This oxygen must exist as molecule. So since oxygen is existing as molecule, this equation is not balanced. If we make oxygen 2, then hydrogen has to be 2. So this is equation of hydrogen reacting with oxygen to form water. What is the mass of hydrogen here? The atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. But we have 2 hydrogen here. 1 times 2 is 2. Then 2 moles. 2 times 2, 4. The total mass of hydrogen here is 4 grams per mole. The mass of oxygen is 16. But we have 1 molecule of oxygen, which is 2 atoms of oxygen. 1 atom of oxygen has mass of 16 grams. 2 atoms, we have 32 grams. Water, 16 plus 2. That is 18 plus times 2, that is 36. So in the reactant part, you see that here is equals 36. Product here is 36. Mass is not created, and this helps in balancing of equation. Any equation, chemical equation that is balanced, if you add the mass of the element or compound in this side, it must be equal to the mass of the element or compound that is not created. It is conserved. However, the discovery of radioactivity is a blow on Dalton's atomic theory, because in radioactivity, we see the disintegration of the nucleus of an atom. Matter, or a heavy nucleus, basically destroys, disintegrates to form smaller particles. So, more of that soon. Atoms of the same elements are identical in all aspects. That is, many atoms of the same elements, they are identical. But some, this is chlorine, you can have chlorine with atomic number 17 and mass number of 35. You can have the same chlorine with atomic number of 17, mass number of 37. So atoms of the same element, they are having different masses, different behavior. So atoms of the same element are not exactly alike. And he also said that atoms of different elements are like atoms of the same elements are different from atoms of other elements. Look at it. Atoms of different elements can have the same mass and the same similar properties. This is referred to as isotopy or isotopes. Atoms of the same element, the same atomic number, they have different atomic mass. Then we have a situation where atoms of different elements, they have the same atomic mass. This is carbon. This is nitrogen. They are atoms of different elements. But you see that they have the same mass. At least they have similar properties. These are referred to as isobars. The ones of the same element but with different mass or structure, they are referred to as isotopes. Isotopy was discovered by W. Einstein. And finally, when atoms combine, they do so in simple ratio. But this is not always the case. Look at this compound. Chloro-octane-decane, C18, H37, and Cl, which is 1. This is 18:37:1. In fact, for water, this is for compound. For water, you see hydrogen is 2, oxygen is 1. It's even 2:1, simple ratio. But look at here, 18:37:1. This is not even simple ratio at all. It's a complex ratio. So, reaction involves separation or combination, rearrangement of atom, but there are other ways reaction can occur. But this is, to an extent, valid. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is atomic theory, or atomic theory generally. That is it for today. In the next class, I will take you through other atomic theories. Trust me, you are going to enjoy them.